I was coming in from the yard and I was walking by a TV and there's TV rooms. It caught my attention. There was a guy sitting there and I asked him what it was and he said it was CrossFit. I was hooked, like I wanted to know everything about it. You know, I saw how they felt about what they were doing, you know, and I wanted that same feeling. My name is Fletcher Tholin. I'm from Alton, Illinois. I'm 26 years old. I've just been released from prison. I served 3 years on a 5-year sentence.
I couldn't help him, you know, and he was in with bad people and I knew it.
He left on bad terms because of things he was doing and I was trying to talk him out of it and he wasn't listening.
I knocked on the door and when he opened the door, then he had a gun in my face.
The only thing that I am proud of that happened during that time is that I discovered CrossFit. One day I'm going to get to walk into a box and there's not going to be any obstacles in between me and just doing a simple workout and hanging out with some positive people. That's all I wanted. It's like I didn't want anything special, but it's like...
What is CrossFit?
Chance to start again. Ah! Do something different this time around.
All weekend long going, oh my God, I really hope that I do not have to call Monday and go, man, I can't get out.
There's 5 level systems in the halfway house. Level 1, you're just gotten here and you're not allowed to do anything. You can't leave, you're stuck here until you take an orientation. And then you'll be on level 2. And level 2 is where I'm currently at. In level 2, you are allowed to go job searching Monday through Friday for 6 hours and that's it. Get employment and you start paying them 25% of your check, you'll move to level 3. Level 3 is you go to work whenever your schedule is for work and you get 2 rec passes a week and you can put them in whenever you want and they're 12 hours.
Which they'll be used here. And then in a week or 2 after that, that's where I want to be. And that's 6 hours every day and 54 hours every weekend. So I might as well just pitch a tent outside of this place and then I'll be moving and grooving then.
Welcome back.
Yeah.
Big day.
Yeah.
Okay, so the athlete area is here. You can set your things anywhere you need to there. And then
okay.
If there's anything you'd like to do to get warmed up or prepared, we'll start promptly at noon.
I'm Greg Skelly, the affiliate owner and head coach at CrossFit Edwardsville. And I also lead all the on-ramps, which is our foundational program for athletes who are new to the game or who are coming into CrossFit from a non-traditional background, like they've been garage CrossFitters or they've come from a gym that didn't have an on-ramp. I make sure that we're all on the same page about a lot of key points of performance and that the athletes know what we're watching for on various lifts and body weight moves. Sometimes we'll see the knees collapse inward as they go. We strive to push the knees out through the whole motion, especially on the way back up. Down, up, down, up. I see good back position here. I see the knees staying out. That's good, Fletcher. I'd say about 6 or 7 years now.
And you're a competitor as well?
Yeah. I actually compete this weekend at the Ice Breather in Springfield. Keep our chest high and that back in a good alignment. Knees out, feet flat, and full range each rep that we do.
I got a job and I was under the impression that you move up to level 3 automatically when you get a job. So I go into his office and I'm like, man, you know, I'm like, so when are you going to put me on level 3? He said, you're not going on level 3. And I'm like, what?
So you have a fake work pass?
Yeah, for today and tomorrow. And I don't like it. It's not like I'm trying to go to the bar or I'm not trying to go somewhere bad. You know, I'm trying to go to a CrossFit gym. They'd probably think I was lying if I told them that. Like, where were you today? I'm like, I went to a CrossFit gym. And they'd be like, okay, that's a nice one. Sure.
This probably happens where you're at. People probably are.
Yeah.
They're being creative and
Like I said before, I'm taking the right path.
You've been setting up every front squat by power cutting it from the ground?
Yeah.
No squat rack?
No.
Man.
I know.
That's what I'm talking about. Like, this kid wants it bad. That's great, man.
Even folks who are self-coached or have done a lot of homework online, there are things that you can't see when you're judging yourself or working on your own abilities that a coach can see. We wanted to be sure that Fletcher was on the same page with the squats or with variations on pull-ups or shoulder to overhead lifts. And he's demonstrated quite a bit of proficiency with these things, but the fundamentals course that we coach is still really, really important for us to know that he's ready to go to regular CrossFit classes and be able to get the most out of them.
I mean, I told myself regardless of what the job was going to be that I was going to do it because it equals to me getting to come here.
So what is your job?
Washing dishes at a bar. I mean, it is what it is, so I mean, I'm not complaining about it. I'm grateful for it, but
How'd you get it? What'd you do?
I just went in there and applied like crazy. I applied for every job under the sun, you know, and just pray that one of them will, you know, hire me.
I was running and I hear someone go, good job. I'm like, what was that? I've never been like complimented or like cheered on, you know, the environment that I've worked in. It's always been negative, so it kind of shocked me. I don't know, it like boosts your confidence, man. It makes you feel good.
I get it, that's good.
That's cool, man. Congratulations.
That's nice. I can sleep finally.
Your shoulders will start down, then you're going to shrug the shoulders to the ears as you go. Okay. Elbow straight, long as you can do, and then drop quick under it. Okay, fantastic. Except I want you to think about one thing. Once that bar is over your knee, you're going to keep your arms straight for as long as possible as you pull quickly. Pop the hips quickly, arms straight, meaning the elbows straight for as long as possible before the drop. So I try hard not to overcoach an athlete when they have good body awareness, good kinesthetic awareness like Fletcher does. So there's a few key things that we'll focus on as we're working through these lifts, and I'll try to reinforce those few key things over and over. A lot of the basics he's already connected with, and I don't have to say it again, he's already got it in his new movement pattern. That's what a great athlete does. They learn very quickly, so this should be good.
How much is that?
205.
Being in the halfway house, it's a ticking time bomb. Because I mean, there are some positive people here, but the majority of them are negative. And when you're surrounded by negative people, it sucks the life out of you. You know, it brings you down.
What percentage of the people in here are negative?
10.
I think one of the greatest things we can offer him here is having that positive kind of environment where everybody around is reinforcing good behaviors and healthy behaviors, which is something that he doesn't have on a regular basis outside of the box.
When I first got here, two guys talked to me, and I talked to them for the first week or two, and they seemed like okay guys. And on the third week, the one guy's getting drinking and he's doing drugs and, you know, he's trying to leave on his passes and go meet girls or go do this and that, you know what I mean? And then I'm just like, yeah, that's when you just gotta be assertive with people and you gotta say, look man, I don't have nothing against you, but the things that you're doing are definitely not the things that I wanna do. I got certain things that I wanna do and we're not on the same page, so I'm not trying to be mean or tell you, you know what I mean, or anything like that, but take a walk, you know? That's something I had a big problem with before I went to prison, because you know, you let people kind of peer pressure you and you let people talk you into doing things that you don't want to do, you know what I mean? And that's how what winded me up in prison.
There are people here who kind of relate to having a more troubled or distressed background. They can buoy him up with encouragement that, hey, you know, your past is your past. It does not dictate your future. And this is like a turning point for him now, where he can now dedicate himself to healthy behaviors, healthy lifestyle, all this cool stuff we get to do here that he couldn't do when he didn't have coaching, when he didn't have a gym, when he didn't have a lot of the resources and equipment that we have here.
What is CrossFit?
To me, CrossFit's a rope that somebody or something lowered down to the bottom of a pit, but it's not pulling me up. I gotta pull myself up. It's giving me what I need, but I gotta put the work in.
I have not kissed a girl in like 4 years.
Yeah, I'm gonna be a little watchful around you. And I'm like, oh, they're doing thrusters, man. I'm really good at thrusters.
I think it's awesome for like the CrossFit community.
Why is this my dream, man?